This is legit the third fucking time that an artist drops an album by surprise on my bitch ass. It started earlier this year in January when Eminem dropped Music to Be Murdered By out of fucking nowhere. And then in March, Gambino decided it'd be funny to drop his album by surprise as well because he's Donald fucking Glover. And now, motherfucking Bad Bunny, this fucking Puerto Rican fuckboy, thinks it's okay to drop a surprise album because he's bored in the house and I'm in the house bored. So fuck it, let's drop a surprise album. Let's make G-Vance's life a lot more fucking hard, as if he doesn't already have a hard time choosing which album is gonna stand out each fucking month. Well, I guess there's only one more thing left for me to do. See you all on the other fucking side. What is up, my beautiful people? My name is G-Benz and welcome back to my channel. And today we're gonna be talking about the new album by Bad Bunny entitled Las Que No Iban a Salir, or in English, The Ones That Weren't Going to Come Out. And yes, that looks very much like the fucking Yeezus album by Kanye. You know, that was my exact first reaction when I saw that shit too. This is the third studio album by Bad Bunny, which comes to us about only 2 months since his second studio album released earlier this year entitled Yo Hago Lo Que Me Da La Gana. You know, that one was filled with classic reggaeton vibes. You know, kind of like going back to the early roots of reggaeton that made it sound really fucking dope. And pretty much what Bad Bunny is here to do is give everybody, not just his fans, but everybody in the whole world, what they've been starving for since the moment this fucking quarantine happened. Some fucking entertainment. So apparently earlier this month, this man went on a 3-hour live stream on Instagram where a shit ton of people around the world were watching. And you know, Bad Bunny, you know, being like the rest of us, you know, stuck in the house, social distancing, which we're all doing really fucking terrible at right now. And just pretty much not being able to leave the house at all was pretty much just sharing like a little bit of like clips and snippets of unreleased songs that he's like working on, or like, you know, that weren't going to come out. And you know, a lot of the people watching were all just dying to hear the new Bad Bunny songs, because obviously they sounded like new Bad Bunny songs, and you know, who doesn't want to hear a new Bad Bunny song these days, you know? So in a way to like give back to his fans and to the whole world who are, you know, stuck in the house with no entertainment, he released a fucking 10-track out of nowhere album of songs that he was not going to release to the public ever. Bad Bunny has been making a fucking comeback this year, and honestly, he's been a really big influential artist for a lot of people. You know, he's dropped a lot of amazing and catchy songs this year that a lot of people, including myself, have been really loving so far. You know, he dropped that really dope album earlier this year, like I said before. You know, it included a lot of the classic and like, you know, great sounds of reggaeton, you know, just him going back to the roots of what made that type of music sound re really, really fucking good at the time. And he even dropped a really inspirational and a really powerful music video earlier this year for Yo Perreo Sola, which that video itself made him probably one of the most important artists that we have right now in modern day times. Honestly, just when you think that Bad Bunny doesn't have anything else up his sleeve, he comes out of nowhere with this fucking self-produced project to cure every one of our quarantine blues. You know, this project is filled with a lot of, you know, demos and unmastered songs, you know, just a bunch of songs that sound like a bunch of fucking throwaways that he felt weren't as good to like put on Yo Hago Lo Que Me Da La Gana, which honestly I kind of wish he did add these songs on that album, because honestly, like, I find myself enjoying this one a lot more than Yo Hago Lo Que Me Da La Gana. Like, I'm not saying that last album was like garbage or anything, but you know, like, this fucking surprise project, like, honestly, like, hit me in a much more different way than like the other one did. And honestly, it's just filled with a lot of great and amazing songs. Honestly, Bad Bunny definitely knows how to start off every fucking project that he makes. You know, I feel that every time I listen to a new Bad Bunny album, it's always the first track on there, the very opening track, that instantly gets me hooked right in. And that's exactly what happened again on this album. That first track entitled Si Ella Sale is was honestly like something I didn't expect. You know, a fucking hardcore trap trap banger that, you know, just had me going, okay, Bad Bunny, what else do you fucking got for me this time? Let's see what this motherfucker does now. The production value on this album is a really big highlight for me. You know, I really love that he does have a bit of a trap style on this album. You know, that's the kind of style that Bad Bunny has been going for the past two albums that he has dropped so far. But I will say that I do love that most of the songs on here are not as much in your face or as hyped as a usual Bad Bunny song is. You know, they're a lot more calm, they're a lot more slower, you know, they're a bit sad if you listen to the lyrics, you know, if you do understand Spanish. And you know, honestly, it's just a whole like big change of scenery from the past two albums that he's dropped, where it was his usual like trap reggaeton style. You know, I really loved how different this was. I really loved that he like wanted to like step outside of his comfort zone here. So yeah, that's the one thing I do appreciate about this album is the amazing production value as always. And even if you feel that it wasn't enough to hear 10 new unreleased tracks from Bad Bunny, the incredible guest list on this album is another big highlight for me at least. For example, Yandel shows up on this album on a track called Canción con Yandel, which that one is surprisingly a very chill and a very calm and slow song. And the reason why I say that is because, you know, usually Yandel does a lot of like hardcore in your face rap tracks. You know, a lot of his albums are really hardcore and in your face, and surprisingly he was not hardcore in this song. You know, he surprised me. You know, he was singing, he didn't rap at all. You know, I don't think there's a single like hip-hop vibe throughout this whole album at least. And yeah, it just really surprised me because when I saw that Yandel was gonna be on this album, you know, I for sure thought that it was gonna be a really like hype and hardcore fucking lyrical rap track. And no, like it was just really chill and calm. You know, he was definitely like going along with the style that Bad Bunny wanted for this entire album. So yeah, I do actually like appreciate that Yandel like toned it down a bit for this album at least. Another example is the track entitled Bad Con Nicki, which has a guest appearance by Nicki Jam himself. You know, he's a really dope and talented Latin singer of our time right now, and I'm not gonna say that that song is more hype and in your face because it really isn't. You know, it's still a lot more chill, but the kind of vibe that this song gives you is as if you're in a nightclub. You know, it's the kind of song that you hear when you're going out to the club with the boys or with the girls or by yourself. You know, that's mostly at me because I'm a fucking lonely piece of shit. But I wouldn't say it's the kind of song that you'd want to dance or party to, even though it does give you like that kind of energy. But I feel like it's the kind of song that I would play in the background for talking music, you know, when I'm in a get together with the boys, or if I'm like driving in the car with my cousin or family. You know, that's just the kind of vibe that this song gives you. But besides the amazing guest list and the great production value that this album has to offer, Bad Bunny himself is by far the biggest highlight throughout this whole album, because I really love how he became really vulnerable and a lot more open throughout this whole album, especially on songs like Bye Me Fui, Bendiciones, and especially En Casita. You know, that one is the final track on this album, and that one is where Bad Bunny is pretty much like just like lets everything out, you know, as if it's a fucking therapy session. You know, this man is like pretty much saying how much he misses his friends, his family, you know, how he's sad that he couldn't see his mom on Mother's Day this year, you know, like how he wishes the virus would just fucking go away finally so everything can get back to normal. Like, I feel like this final track is like showing that Bad Bunny like has obviously been really affected by the quarantine, and you know, just how much is like really like fucking with his head. Honestly, this album is really therapeutic for those of you that are really struggling with the quarantine right now, especially those with really bad mental health issues. You know, I know that the quarantine is not helping out with that. I know that it's making it a lot more worse. And I think that's how Bad Bunny intended this album to be, you know. And that's another thing that I appreciate about Bad Bunny is that once again, he's thinking of not himself, but of everyone around the world. And just, you know, when he makes music, he just always like wants to help people out, especially during these like really unfortunate and uncertain times. Overall, this album is proof that even during quarantine and even during a fucking crisis like the one we're facing right now, Bad Bunny is always on the grind. He is never like not working on his music and on his business and all that. And I highly, highly recommend this one to each and every one of you. You know, I can't really think of what's my favorite track on this album, so fuck it. I'm gonna say they're all fucking good. They're all like really amazing. They're all really catchy. You know, you guys are not gonna like get disappointed by this album. And honestly, this just has me like thinking of what other like unreleased like content and material is this man like sitting on, you know? Like I'm really like fucking wondering right now. So yeah, I definitely can't wait to hear what else Bad Bunny is gonna do next. Thank you guys so much for watching. Hope you guys enjoyed my review. Don't forget to like, subscribe, click that bell down below, all that good stuff, so you don't miss a single one of my uploads whatsoever. And don't forget to stay happy. Viniste buscándome porque te fallaron de